Good morning, students. Today we will discuss few questions of exercise 8.2, especially example number 8 and example number 9. These are very important questions. How to solve these questions? Let's discuss. Here is example number 8. The question is, the second, third and fourth terms in the binomial expansion x plus a whole power n are 240, 720 and 1080 respectively. Find the values of a, x and n. As we know, expansion is given here x plus a whole power n. In general, we learn the expansion, which in previous lecture I told you. Expansion is, let's write down. Yes, that expansion is a plus b whole power n, that is equal to n c 0 a to the power n b to the power 0 plus n c 1 a to the power n minus 1 b to the power 1 plus n c 2 a to the power n minus 2 b to the power 2, and that is last term is ncn a to the power 0 b to the power n. Now here expansion is this one. What is the change? Replace a by x and b by a and n is equal to n. So what? This expansion can be written as, in the replacing the value a as x, b as a, you will get the new expansion. As I have told you in previous lecture, what is the general term? General term will be equal to, for this expansion, especially I have written here, that is tr plus 1, that is equal to ncr a to the power n minus r b to the power r. For this expansion especially, which I have written, this one expansion. If you want the general term of the expansion, this one, x plus a whole power n, then you have to replace what? These values. What you will get? Look here. You will get the terms like this. Tr plus 1 will be equal to ncr and x to the power n minus r into a to the power r. Because what? What is b? B is a and a is x. Now this is a general term of the given expansion. What is the requirement now further? Requirement is, you have to find the second term and third term, fourth term. Second, third and fourth term you have to find out. What you will do? In general, when you put r is equal to 1. Here when you put r is equal to 1, r is 1, then 1 plus 1 will be 2. So what? You will get the second term. So put r is equal to 1 in the general term, you will get the second term. That is t2 is equal to nc1 x to the power n minus 1 a to the power 1. Or you can write that nc1 x to the power n minus 1 into a. This is the second term. Now for the third term, here when you want 3, it means r you have to put equal to 2. So put r is equal to 2, you will get the third term. When you put r is equal to 3, you will get the fourth term. Now you got second term, third term and fourth term. Now your target is to solve these three equations and find out the value of x, a and n. First quantity, second quantity and index. You have to find out these three values. What to do? In the previous classes, up to 10th class, when you solve two equations, normally you add two equations, subtract two equations, and you will get the values of the given x and y or any other variable. But in the case of this question, when you want to solve these three equations, you have to divide the equations. Now, this is the first time you are doing. So, how to do? Let's see. According to the given. Now second term is given to you, that is equal to 240. It means nc1 x to the power n minus 1 a will be written as 240. Second term is equal to 720, it is given to you. And third term is given, that is 1080. It means second term, third term and fourth term are given to you. These are three equations. Now divide second equation by first equation. How to divide? Let's see. Second by first. Now second equation, left hand side part of the second equation in the numerator, and right hand side, both sides, you have to divide them. When you are dividing and simplifying, you are getting what? Here is nc2 x to the power n minus 2 a to the power 2, nc1 x to the power n minus 1 into a is equal to 720 upon 240. Left and right both sides of the second equation and first equation. Second equation divided by the first equation. You will get this one. Okay. Now expand this ncr, applying the formula of ncr, factorial n upon factorial 2, factorial n minus 2. And this is, solve the this second one denominator part. Denominator part will be factorial n upon. Upon means come to the numerator. Root, factorial 1 into factorial n minus 1. Now x of the numerator and denominator can be solved like this. 1 upon x to the power n minus 1 minus n, change the sign, plus 2. And a's are calculated, a to the power 2 minus 1. Where the power is more, you have to shift the statement there. Okay. Here x to the power n minus 1 is, n minus 1 is greater 1. So what? Take the n minus to the denominator. In the case of here a, the power of numerator is more, take the denominator power to the numerator power. So simplify it like this. What you will get? It becomes a, this becomes x, because minus 1 plus 2, this is x to the power 1. Here to simplify the factorial part, factorial n cancelled by factorial n. And you can simplify this factorial n minus 1. What is the meaning of factorial? One less you can write, and next one will be written as a factorial. N minus 1 as it is, one less, that is n minus 2, I write it as factorial n minus 2. Cancel them, what you are getting? N minus 1 upon 2. Now simplify it, you are getting a upon x is equal to 6 upon n minus 1. This is a ratio of a minus x upon 6 minus n minus 6 upon n minus 1. Let this is the equation number 4. Now divide third equation by second equation. In the on the first page you have written third divided by second. Now when you are dividing third by second, what you will do? Simplify the combination part, take the power of x simplified and power of a simplified, and right hand side these two numbers have to simplify. How to simplify? Yes, similar way as I have done in the previous one. Factorial n upon factorial 3 minus factorial n minus 3. Factorial n upon, upon part will go in a numerator. Root angle, factorial 2 into factorial n minus 2, and solve the powers of x and powers of a and simplify the numbers in the right hand side. What you will get? First of all, I think you have to remember how to solve the factorial here again. N minus 2 can be written as n minus 2 into factorial n minus 3, 1 less. When you subtract 1 from this n minus 2, you will get n minus 3. That is factorial n minus 3. Cancel the n minus 3 factorial and simplify it. Again, you are getting a ratio of a upon x. Now, two equations you got, equation 4 and equation 5, in which a upon x ratio you got. Now compare these two ratios, 4 and 5. From 4 and 5, comparing these two ratios, putting the values of a upon x from 4 to 5, what you are getting after cross multiplication? The value of n will be equal to 5. Simplify it and you will get n is equal to 5. Now next target is to solve. Let's see. One thing I have to told before we proceed. One thing I have to told you here. The value of, I'm writing here, the when you are getting n is equal to 5, when a upon x is equal to a upon 2 into 5 minus 2. If you put the value of 5 in the equation 5. What you are getting? A upon x is equal to 9 upon 2 into 3, that is 9 upon 6. You can say 3 2s are 3, 3s are 3 upon 2. It means A upon x comes out equal to 3 upon 2. Here one thing you have to remember. If this is in the standard form, standard form means it is in the when after cancellation of this, you are getting 9 upon 6. 9 upon 6 is cancelled and then you are getting this one. It means this is in a standard form. Further, it cannot be simplified. Then you can say that only then, if it is in a standard form, then you can say that A is 3 and X is 2. This is the value. And you already got N is equal to 5. So A is equal to 3 you get and X is equal to 2. It means the question is done. If you know about it when it is in a standard form, only you can compare these two sides. Okay. If you don't know, then how to proceed the question further? Let's see. Now put the value of 5 in the above equations. Now from equation first, when you put n is equal to 5, you are getting 5 times of x to the power 4 into a is equal to 240. And when you put n is equal to 5 in equation 4, use previous equations. Okay. Now you are getting a upon x is equal to 3 upon 2. Now put the value of a from this. A is equal to 3 by 2 into x. Put this value in the 6th equation. What you are getting from 6 and 7? You are getting x to the power 5 is equal to 32. And simplify it, you are getting x is equal to 2. If you got n is 5, x is 2, then what you have to find out? A. Put the value of x here and you will get the value of a, that is 3. Now answer is x is 2, a is 3 and n is equal to 5. You can get the value of a and x by using this concept also. Now for further. Now example number 9. In previous question, we talked about the terms of the given expansion. Now we'll talk about the coefficients of the three consecutive terms. As you know, consecutive means what? Lagatar. Lagatar jo terms aate hain, usse kehte hain consecutive terms. Okay, the coefficients of three consecutive terms in the expansion are in the ratio 1 ratio 7 ratio 42. Find the value of n. Now, as whenever question is there, first of all, you have to find out the general term. Here, I have told you in a previous question to you, what is the formula to solve the general term? Tr plus 1 is equal to ncr a to the power. What is a? 1. A to the power n minus r, b. B is a. A to the power r. Now, what is the general term? ncr a to the power r. Now, this is a general term. What are the coefficient? I have highlighted here, ncr is a coefficient of the general term. What you observe here? What you are observing here? When term is r plus 1, then you are getting coefficient ncr. Here is r, 1 less. It is r plus 1, then it is r. When it is r, then it will be r minus 1. If it is r plus 2, then it will be r minus 1. So observe it. When you are talking about the general term, what type of coefficient you are getting? Now, if I am talking about the three consecutive terms, coefficients, then what I have to opt? Then we have to opt what? R minus 1 at term, r at term, r plus 1 at term. Now you have to pick coefficient of r minus 1 at term, rth term and r plus 1 at term, because coefficients ratio is given to you. Okay. Now what is the r minus 1 at term? That is ncr minus 2 a to the power r minus 2, because when you put here what? Minus 2, r plus 1 will be r minus 1. When you will get put here? When you put r minus 2 here at the place of r, then you are getting r minus 1. It means what? 1 less. R plus 1, it is r. R plus 1, 1 less is r minus 2. Observe it. If tr you are calculating, you are getting r minus 1. When you are getting r plus 1, you are getting coefficient with r. Okay. Now consecutive terms coefficients are ncr minus 2, ncr minus 1, ncr. Think, observe carefully. In previous question, we talked about only terms. Now coefficients of terms. In previous question, we solved the terms. Now here we will solve the ratio of the coefficients only. Okay. Same procedure will be applied. When I divide this here NCR 2 by NCR minus 1, we are getting what ratio is given? 1 ratio 7. Where is the? Yes. This ratio is given to you. 1 ratio 7 ratio 42. It means 1 is the ratio first, this is second, and this is third. You are getting what? When first ratio, first coefficient is divided by second coefficient, you are getting 1 upon 7. When dividing second coefficient by third coefficient, you are getting 7 upon 42. Now simplify by using the NCR formula. By using NCR, applying this that NCR formula in denominator and numerator both. Here numerator and denominator both. And you are getting two equations in R and N. Two equations in N and R. And solve those two equations and you will get the value of N and R. Let's see how to do. Yes. I simplified here the left part. You can see here I just applied the formula of NCR in numerator and denominator and simplified it. I just observed that which factorial you have, you can cancel. Here, when you take this factorial n minus r plus 2, when you take 1 less, what you will get? N minus r plus 1, which is a part of the numerator. So what? Expand it. Factorial n minus r plus 2. What you are getting? The factorial part of the numerator, you will cancel it. And what you are getting? Now, after simplifying r minus 1, you are getting r minus 1 into factorial r minus 2. Cancel this. What you are getting? R minus 1 upon n minus r plus 2 is equal to 1 upon 7. Cross multiplication take place. And what you will get? N minus 8r plus 9 equal to 0. Okay. Now simplify the second part here on. I have simplified it. Observe the part second solution. And you will get the second equation. N minus 7r plus 1 equal to 0. And first and second two equations are here. As in class 10th, when you get the equation in xy, you can solve it by using substitution method, by using the comparing the coefficient method and the cross multiplication method. Choice is yours. What method you applied to calculate the value of n and r. Now simplify equation first and second both by taking any of the method. Then you will get the value of n and r both. Here only requirement of n is there. That's why I have written n is equal to 55. You will get after solving the equation first and second. Try to solve these question. Do your own. Try to do your own. And such type of questions in exercise 8.2 and in miscellaneous also. Do those questions. Try those questions. I hope you will do these questions now. Thank you. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.